Philippines, where satellites have shown no further emissions. While the Taal volcano was going off, local officials said that pressure was building for an even larger eruption. And I really hope they were wrong, because it's now been 2 days of that building when they said the bigger one was hours away. Hopefully this pristine return remains. Meanwhile, now is the winter of the Middle Easterners' discontent. Snow, freezing cold, and avalanches have killed more than 100 people. I won't show the shots, but all the kids in the news photos are in shorts. Let's come to the analysis portion, where the Puerto Rico 6.4 earthquake has been mapped using ground motion remote sensing. About 5.5 inches of motion in the red region, towards the southeast and down in elevation. These scientists have a question about whether geoengineering will be able to help. I'm just going to cut them off right there. No. Up next, we're going to test to locate slight motions of other stars they say were part of a great ancient collision of the Milky Way. We'll forget for a moment that having even 1% of stars in hyperbolic or unbound orbits debunks the galactic rotation problem and need for dark matter, and just see here how there are numerous pathways stars are taking around the galactic center. Basically these, and everything in between. The first of those trifecta movie-related stories hits the climate. They're going to have to take how much methane they think is coming out of the Arctic and basically cut it in half. There is an incredible halting of the release when cold water conditions emerge at the deep, locking up many of the methane flares and slow releases. That's not only going to affect the human attribution portion of the models, given that 60% of global warming is confined to the Arctic Circle, but also the forecasts of future warming. Take them down, big guys. Nova up next, and they have spotted four of what they call dwarf nova. Now, they say these are accretion disk brightenings, which only half makes sense, and further has no direct observation. They guess it's the disk because these nova are so small. In fact, many come in around 10 to the 31 ergs of power, which is even smaller than the Carrington Event solar flare of 1859, the 1957 blast, and probably a few more the sun releases every other cycle or so. From dwarf nova to hypernova, we cover a 100 trillion x...